Former principal at Hodgson, Principal Al Hardy over at Greenwood College School, and the family and friends of Margery Winkler. We're so pleased to have you here. We have a number of people who are going to speak. I'm going to start with David Ehrlich, who was principal at Hodgson for a long time.
It's great to see everyone, by the way. It brings back fantastic memories. So I wrote some things down because I didn't want to miss anything. So in the spring of 2003, at a school council meeting, the decision to move out of the learning space was discussed at Hodgson. And today, the kids at Hodgson experience daily Margery's vision, hard work, and dedication. From the moment the idea was brought up, Margery was committed to this project. I remember that night, because it was brought up by the staff, very quickly they turned to me and said, "David, you don't have to worry because the person who can run this project is in the room." And that was Margery. They told me that Margery was the one that had developed the Morris Cody Gardens and had done lots of other work within the community. And she was perfect for the job. So construction began in the spring of 2006. And throughout the process, Margery was the driving force. She met with the city as well as the school board on numerous occasions to show them our plans and to talk about the process we were following. She wrote many, many proposals. She developed a class assignment for her students at Ryerson that involved us at Hodgson developing possible models for the school.
Thank you to our city councilor, Josh Matlow, who supported our dream from the beginning. Doc, remember that fateful day you walked up to a house on Belfast campaigning, where luckily all of Margie's girlfriends were gathered to discuss this project and meet Jesse for the very first time. Talk about faith. You voiced your support at that very first moment you mentioned it to. Thank you for your continued interest and support and announcement of the funds allocated to the project. Words do not adequately express our very special thank you to our school trustees, but especially friends, Shelley Lasker, who was a tremendous behind-the-scenes advisor, director, facilitator. Shelley quietly and steadily advanced this project from dream to reality. With your contacts and leads, you helped facilitate the donation process by hooking us up to the Toronto Foundation for Student Success so people could donate online. You put us in contact with people in the board and in the neighborhood. We are so grateful for your calm and steady help. You are definitely the person to go to when you want something done around here. Thank you to all of you, us, family, friends, neighbors, colleagues, members of Hodgson and Ryerson communities, for jumping on board with your generous contribution. This showed the true spirit that Margie believed in to raise a child. Many of us experienced Margie in different ways, be it on a bike ride, a walk of joy, a girl's getaway, a family trip, a meal, a lecture at Ryerson, a book club that she instigated, a nature walk, a coffee on Bayview, or simply a heart-to-heart talk. Whatever the activity, the connection was often spiritual. Our hope is that this bench offers you the opportunity to return to that sweet memory you have of our beloved Margie while sitting in the very setting that she and her students created. So friends, neighbors, students, please drive by, walk by, sit down, and think of Margie as a lasting tribute to her. We'd love to know you're here.
I would just like to express my thanks and gratitude to Shelley, our good friend. Dave, you've done wonderful work, and Hajo was always saying how much fun we're working with you. And also, the great principal. And of course, there is the gang leader, Perla. Perla, the gang leader, and the entire gang that helped this project and contributed to this cause. We have a piece of stone at the cemetery that commemorates Margie's passing. And now we have a beautiful stone sculpture that actually commemorates her life. I would also like to say thank you to Jesse. Jesse, you never met her, but based on your work, the expression in your art, I know that you knew her. It just feels like you've always known her. I would like to say one more thing. The monster called cancer is taking a lot of us prematurely. It has taken on Margery, it has taken Jack recently, Jack Layton. It has taken Steve, using this person name on purpose, Steve Jobs. And I would like to ask all of you to do whatever you can to stop the monster, to beat it. We have to work together to beat it. And I hope that we can one day see the world without it.
Thank you.
It's gorgeous.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
If you guys have a seat on it, family, I'll just take a quick shot. Send it to Florida.
the time you let me know what's real and going on below. But now you never show it to me, do you? And remember when I moved in you, the holy dark was moving too, and every breath we drew was hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. God above, and all I ever learned from love was how to shoot at someone who outdrew you. And it's not a cry you can hear at night, it's not somebody who's seen the light, it's a cold and it's a